Hello there, I'm Anime Master, and welcome to my Sonic 1 level editing tutorial. The first part we're going to go over in level editing is the layout. Okay. So, you want to edit, say, Green Hill Zone 1, we want to start editing our Sonic 1 ROM, we want to do the layout. Now, the first thing we want to do is we want to have a split disassembly. So, I've got this guy open here, his name is Q Jimbo. I'll most certainly put him in the video description as well. And he will basically explain, we need a Sonic 1 split disassembly. He'll explain how to basically split disassembly. And he'll probably go over here, or explain, if you go over to that Sonic Retro, you can just go to www.sonicretro.org, or I may just put info.org, and put you straight over to the how to setup guides, and basically these are the files you want, and he'll go over that. So I don't want to go over this too much, this is about level editing, this is not really about split assembly, but make sure you've got that set up. And because we're editing Green Hill Zone 1, you want to go back and go to his channel. I'll just show you very quickly. And we want to follow this guide here. And this will basically show you how to fix Green Hill Zone. Right, so make sure you follow this tutorial. I'm not going to show it because I've already done it. But I'll just go on the link here. And Kujimbo here will just basically, he'll explain, he'll tell you how to fix Green Hill Zone 1. Okay, now once you've got all this set up, just come back to me. Feel free to minimize this or open up a new tab while you do so. What, assuming now you've set up your assembly, I'll just show you mine, Sonic 1 Fresh. All my files are split here. I've got my Sonic 1 film, got my project files, which are the files that need to be opened, and the program we're opening is SonicD2. As you may have seen here, I've got SonicD folder. Now I've got SonicD2 down here. Of course, I've already got it open. So, and I'll just show you. We go to File at the top of SonicD2, Open, and we've got the list of levels from Green Hill Zone to Scrap Brain Zone, and I'll just select that. And if you've fixed correctly the Green Hill Zone, this is what you should get. Whole of Green Hill Zone Act 1. So this is fixed for all three acts, which is marvellous. We can now edit Green Hill Zone. Now I'm just going to quickly go over, before we touch into actual level editing, I'm just going to go over what we can do here. We've obviously got open, save, import. If you want to import images, again I'll probably go over this in a later tutorial. We've got tile editing, again you can press I for this. Object editor, again you can press O. Level editor, which is what we're seeing here, which is the foreground, again you can press L. You can press P or go to click on level editor plane B, which is the background. Okay. Alright. Now I'm just going to quickly show you a tile editor. I'm going to go over this most likely in more detail in a later tutorial, but I'm just going to briefly show you what basically SonicD2 can offer us. So as you see here, we've got the different chunks. These are the chunks that you place together in the level to create your level layout. You can scroll down here, and if you click on block selector, and you've got the little 16x16 blocks, the blocks that make up, as you can see here, to make up the chunks. And of course the actual art itself, the tiles, and then the little 8x8. And here you've got the palette lines, so this is palette 0, 1, 2, 3, and you can basically edit the palette, edit the mappings, edit the tile, and yeah. And if you've got solid, but again I'll touch up on this in the later tutorial. Okay, but for now we're going to go for the level F. But now, I'll just read that, and in a second we'll be touching up in level editing, the actual layout editing itself. All right, it's now the time to start editing our level. So now we've got our program open up in SunEd2 or SunEd2, SunEd2, I should say, if you prefer. And of course, we've got Windows M1 here, and we've got our objects, we've got our layout, we've got our chunks here. So we're going to start with something easy. Now, we can go here and we can just go to. No, we've gone to the tile editor. Again, you can press I or just click on the editor up here. And you can just select this blank chunk, 0. And as you may have known, this is a chunk if you just want to get rid of that. And then we can press Z to go forward, or A to go back. It'll eventually take you back to the background. And basically switch our chunks. But because of Sonic's position, and we cannot change, and we don't really want to put, say, a really high chunk like this, because he'll fall through the ground. So we're just going to leave the chunk where we know he'll be able to basically stand on. And instead, we're going to edit the chunk next to it. So you can experiment a bit, but just have a feel of basically what you're going to fit here. Something different. Okay, so we've put this here. Right, but now this doesn't make sense. All right, so let's get rid of this, and there we have it. We've made sort of like a little ramp that goes down here. All right, and we can, I don't know, let's say we could change something else. We could perhaps, if you would like, we could I don't know, anything really. You can just sort of experiment. Nothing too major. How about let's get rid of this one. Let's get rid of this one over here. Okay. See, can we replace something? That's slightly different. Now, don't worry about the objects. We'll get to that in a moment. And yeah, I don't want to do too much. I'm just going to basically show you. And that's basically it for level editing. You know, you can hire a route, go through pressing Z and A on the keyboard, just going through different chunks, put it together. Let's see what you can come up with. But before you go a bit crazy, I'd advise you carry on watching this tutorial, because I'm going to touch up on my do's and don'ts and common mistakes that people tend to make when they first make their hacks and release them. So please bear with me and stay with me if you can. Thanks. And now we've briefly gone over the chunks. I'll touch up on the chunks again in a little bit. We're now going to do object editing. Now, of course, you can see we've got rings here, and we can just grab the rings with the left clicking on the mouse, and we can just move it about. Place it here, we can place it there, we can place it anywhere we like. I'm just going to put it here. And also, with the rings, if we want to scroll through, we want only one ring, say. If we press S, we can go back. If we press X, we can go forward. And if we carry on pressing X, we can make a longer trail of rings. And we can keep pressing X. And the more you press it, you can see the rings start to separate a bit further. And if you keep doing it, there you go. We've got a trail that goes down now. So we can always have a trail going down, but we're just going to quickly go back, and we're just going to have those lovely three rings that we had. Keep going back. Yeah, I think that's about right. Alright, if we place that, we're just going to place that here. And you can do the same for the monitor. So we've got a ring box here. If we just press X, we've got the unknown monitor. Press X again, we've got another one. And if we press S and we go down and we go to, see here, we've got the invincibility, we've got the shield, and we've got the speed shoes, and of course the life, and then of course you've got the egg armor, it doesn't do anything. Okay. Well, we're going to put the speed shoes, okay? Now, because of the way it's set up, I'm going to put it in the trees again, but because we changed it, I'm going to put it there, so it's hidden away. Again, the motorbug, I'm just going to position that sort of around there, so it doesn't look odd and out of place. Again, we've still got the spring here, so I'll leave that hidden. I'm just going to put that down a bit like that. Again, you could always separate this if you wanted to. I could just do this, do four. Just have a little separation like that. And you can move this down, you can move this up, whatever you like. Extend the bridge, you know, with different chunks you have. Let's position these crabs here. Put one here instead. Let's move the rock. Or if you like, seems I'll delve into more objects. I'm thinking, nah, I don't want this. I don't want a greenhouse and rock right here. I don't want it at all. Let's double click. And we've got all the objects. And the objects in the game, obviously the undefined are no objects, of course. And yeah, so you can scroll through and see the different objects that you've got. But in this case, I don't want anything, so I'm just going to put null. So I've got no green hill zone rock anymore, so that's what I want. And I'm just going to extend this rings again. I'm just going to put four, and I'm just going to remember the X and S buttons. They'll be common useful tips there, so make sure to get used to the feel of the keypad, the little key controls, because you'll be using them a lot. And yeah. I never actually knew why. I don't know. I think I've slightly altered that. But I'm going to put the motor bug up here anyway. So, but yeah, you want to make sure you want to put things. Don't leave things floating about. But I'll touch up on that. So yeah. So we've briefly had a go. Just a quick note about the rings. Try not to add too many extra rings than there already are in the game, because it can cause problems having too many objects on screen, cause rings to be deleted, and you'll be running around thinking, there should be two rings here, when there's actually perhaps three rings, which is very confusing. So just a quick note on that. But that's basically it. We can just double click anywhere, start a new object, and just grab something. Gonna randomly put something there and just experiment. And again, if you really want, again, you can just sort of scroll through. And just for a little tip, if you want to reverse the motorbug's direction, we're going to scroll instead of S and X, we're going to go to the next two, D and C. Now if we press C, and that'll go up, and there you can see I've just switched direction. But in this case, I'm just going to leave the motorbug like that. So again, A and Z to switch objects, and when you're in chunk mode, plain A. And for switching, like for monitors and stuff, you press X and Z for rings. And if you want to reverse an enemy or so, or say a spring perhaps, then you scroll through between C and D, like so. Alright, well, hang on, we don't want to save it yet. This doesn't look right, does it? No, this doesn't look right either. So how are we going to fix it? More chunks? Yep, we're going to put a chunk here. So what we're going to do is we're going to scroll through and we're going to see if there's a chunk that would work. You're going to scroll through. Look at that. Seems to work. Does it look alright? Yeah. And just for good measure, I'm just going to put one at the top just in case somehow play ends up at the top and thinks, ooh, there's just this empty space and looks a bit odd. But chances are, if they use debug mode, they won't go any further than that. So I'll leave it like it is. But now it looks better, doesn't it? It looks cleaner, fresher. It's already starting to sort of look new. So we do the same for this. We go over here. And if you've ever thought that level editing is hard, it isn't really. It's not really that difficult. With the programs we've got these days, it is rather simple. We could always do a slight alternate route. I suppose you could a higher bass up the top. But in this case, we're just going to use the same chunk because it works. Okay? So now we've already got a more sort of complete looking. And so now I'm just going to save it, save project.